The General Motors EMD locomotives have gained dominance of the unwired sections of Indian Railways since 1999, when the GT46MAC, a.k.a. WDG4, started duties on Indian rails. A passenger version, the GT46PAC or WDP4, soon followed in 2001. But this was not the first time that EMD had set foot in India. EMD locomotives made their first appearance in India as the WDM4 in the 1960s as a competing option against the ALCo DL560 locomotives for the Indian Railways. But because of GM's refusal to transfer technology, WDM4, despite its higher speed and technical superiority, lost the battle of Indian Rails to rival ALCOs. With a top speed of 140 km per hour, the WDM4 was the fastest locomotive in India in the 60s and 70s and served as a link for the Howrah Rajdhani until the advent of the WAP1. The WDG4 and WDP4, powered by a G16-710G3B 16-cylinder 2-stroke diesel engine, were vastly more powerful than anything that the existing ALCOs had to offer. With 3-phase AC traction motors, the locomotives were state-of-the-art with fuel injection, self-diagnostics and microprocessor control for optimum power delivery to the traction motors. In contrast to the COCO arrangement of a WDG4, the WDP4 had bow 1, 1 bow wheel arrangement. This made the 4000 horsepower locomotives light and fast. A WDP4 could run to a top speed of 180 km per hour. However, having just 4 traction motors meant that the locomotive had a low tractive effort of 28 tons. This caused difficulties in hauling trains that were becoming longer, and the locomotive suffered from performance problems and wheel slips. To overcome the performance issues of the WDP4 with respect to heavy hauling, the railways undertook development of the WDP4B. The WDP4B is not an upgrade of the WDP4, but rather is a re-geared version of the WDG4. I have discussed about gear ratios, tractive effort and speed here. The development of the WDP4B is somewhat similar to the development of the WAP7 from the WAG9. The WDP4B has a power output of 4,500 horsepower and a starting tractive effort of 40.7 tons. This meant that the WDP4B could haul a 24-car train at speeds of 130 to 135 kilometers per hour. However, one complaint still remained. At 19.9 meters, both the WDP4 and the WDG4 are exceptionally long locomotives. In comparison, an ALCo WDM series locomotive is 17.12 meters long. This led to complaints from the pilots about visibility when driving with long hood forward. Although the railways have not acknowledged visibility issues in long hood forward mode, they did develop the WDP4D and the WDG4D versions with dual cabs for passenger and freight duties. The D stands for dual cab and not for horsepower. The additional cab appears a bit ungainly, but it makes operations easier for the loco pilots. The WDP4D is only the second dual cab diesel locomotive in India after the WDP3A. WDG4G from GE Transportation is also a dual cab locomotive. This is a brief summary of the technical specifications of the WDP4B and WDP4D. The WDG4 that preceded the WDP4 by 2 years is a powerful locomotive. Initial models put out 4,000 horsepower, but the engine was soon tweaked to 4,500 horsepower. With 53 tons tractive effort, the locomotive could effortlessly pull a fully loaded 58 wagon box and load up a 2.5% gradient. I have explained the working of diesel electric locomotives here. Briefly, the working mechanism of a EMD WDP4 or WDG4 locomotive is as follows. The prime mover, the 16-cylinder two-stroke diesel engine, drives an alternator. The alternator provides the electrical energy that drives the traction motors. EMD locomotives have a dynamic braking system that works in combination with the air brake system to achieve efficient braking. The dynamic brakes are used to control the speed of the train on a continuous down gradient as well as on a level section. When the locomotive is operating in dynamic braking, the traction motors operate as generators. The electrical power generated by the traction motors is converted into heat in braking grids. This heat is dissipated into the atmosphere by the dynamic brake fan and motor assembly. The dynamic brake grid motor is powered by a portion of the electricity generated by the traction motors during dynamic braking operation. Although the traction motor drives and accelerates the train, during braking, it acts as an electric generator instead, forming part of a circuit that consists of a main resistor, armatures, and a field system. Electricity flows through the circuit and is consumed by the main resistor, which converts the kinetic energy of the train into heat and thereby acts as a brake by slowing down the rotation of the traction motors. The WDP4 and WDG4 locomotives are capable of operation in multiple unit configuration. About 3 years back, I had spotted two WDP4D units hauling the Kochuveli Express in the Yalahanka-Yeshwanpur section. This is not a super fast train, nor is it very long. Yet, two WDP4D units were in the lead. That was a total of 9,000 horsepower. At first, I thought it could be a loco failure. But then, I spotted the same combination on two more consequent occasions. I have no answers why two locos were on duty for a non-superfast train. With the Indian Railways now moving towards 100% route electrification, these diesel behemoths have their days numbered. The railways have already designed and rolled out dual traction mode WDAP5 locomotive, which can use electric traction under the wires and run on diesel when the tracks are not electrified. Also, the railways are planning on conversion of these locomotives to electric traction in preparation for 100% electrification of the network. What are your views? Please share in the comment section. If you like this video and other videos on my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon.